James did not see the Fat Controller for several days. They left James alone in the shed and didn't even allow him to go out and push coaches and trucks in the yard. Oh dear, he thought sadly, I'll never be allowed out anymore. I shall have to stay in this shed for always, and no one will ever see my red coat again. Oh dear, oh dear. James began to cry. Just then the Fat Controller came along. I see you are sorry, James, he said. I hope now that you will be a better engine. You've given me a lot of trouble. People are laughing at my railway, and I don't like that at all. I'm very sorry, sir, said James. I will try hard to behave. That's a good engine, said the Fat Controller kindly. I want you to pull some trucks for me. Run along and find them. So James puffed happily away. Here are your trucks, James, said the little tank engine. Have you got some boot laces ready? And he ran off laughing rudely. Oh, 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 said the trucks as James backed down on them. We want a proper engine, not a red monster. James took no notice and started as soon as the guard was ready. Come along, he puffed. We won't, screamed the trucks. But James didn't care, and he pulled the screeching trucks sternly out of the yard. The trucks tried hard to make him give up, but he still kept on. Sometimes their brakes would slip on, and sometimes their axles would run hot. Each time they'd have to stop and put the trouble right, and each time James would start again, determined not to let the trucks beat him. Give up, you can't pull us, you can't, said the trucks. I can and I will, puffed James. And slowly but surely, he pulled them along the line. At last they saw Gordon's Hill ahead. Look out for trouble, James, warned his driver. We'll go fast and get them up before they know it. Don't let them stop you. So James went faster, and they were soon halfway up the hill. I'm doing it, he panted, but it was hard work. Will the top never come, he thought, when with a sudden jerk it all came easier. I've done it, he puffed triumphantly. Hurrah, he thought, it's easy now. But his driver shut off steam. They've done it again, he said, we've left our tail behind. The last 10 trucks were running backwards down the hill. The coupling had snapped. But the guard was brave. Very carefully and cleverly, he made them stop. Then he got out and walked down the line with his red flag. That's why it was easy, said James, as he backed the other trucks carefully down. What silly things trucks are. There might have been an accident. Meanwhile, the guard stopped Edward, who was pulling 3 coaches. Shall I help you, James? Called Edward. No, thank you, answered James. I'll pull them myself. Good, don't let them beat you. So James got ready. Then with a peep, peep, he was off. I can do it, he puffed. He pulled and puffed as hard as he could. Peep, 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 you're doing well, whistled Edward, as James slowly struggled up the hill with clouds of smoke and steam pouring from his funnel. I've done it, he panted, and disappeared over the top. They reached their station safely. James was resting in the yard when Edward puffed by with a cheerful peep, peep. Then, walking towards him across the rails, James saw the Fat Controller. Oh dear, what will he say? He asked himself sadly. But the Fat Controller was smiling. I was in Edward's train and saw everything, he said. You've made the most troublesome trucks on the line behave. And for that, you deserve to keep your red coat.